Coach. I think the title for this will be Stratocaster, where are we at and where can we go? It's just not working right, and it's a lot of good parts, and it's a good guitar. We need to figure it out. Stand by.
So I'm really hurting, folks. I screwed up my back. Let's just tune it up. Always the G string. Alright, we're tuned up. As always, it's that Wheel of Fortune. You know, TV game. Does the truss rod actually do what it's supposed to do? So right now, 17th fret, capo in the first, looking at the 7th, the neck is not straight enough. Let's correct that. Get you guys down in the movie here. Righty tighty, lefty loosey. Oh, it's not stripped. It's turning, so we give it like an eighth of a turn. If it was ever set right in the first place, it shouldn't be more than like a quarter turn in either direction. Right? This is where everybody screws up, because their guitar isn't playing right, and they immediately go to the bridge saddles. That's just truss rod. So I'd even give that another little twist. And the big issue is the frets are just choking out in this area, and we'll talk about that in a minute. So that's about another eighth of a turn. Right? And the nut, there's issues down there, but we'll get there, right? That's the last thing to do. I'm going to stop there, just because I can. Next, let's check out the string height and see if that's within the realms of reality. It's actually set slightly on the high side, but it's all it's fairly consistent. It's a little wiggly, but what we get is those are clean. No. Choke. So there's something going on that ain't right. What happens, bolt-on necks are great, but over time, the four screws pulling into that area, and the truss rod ends about there, we end up with some wiggly shit going on down there. So check with the rocker. Yeah, right there. Right there. So that'll kill everything. One high fret at the very end. Yeah. Okay, so we're fairly, we could go at it spot leveling and probably fix that, but it's just best to go over everything. So the neck comes off and it's a complete fret leveling crowning polish, and then we'll go at it again with this amazing Floyd Rose bridge and some very cool electronics. Anyway, it's getting ripped apart. I digress a little bit, because when we looked at it together, there was too low. We have a new nut. I'm going to reserve that to the very end after I level the frets. And there is a possibility we just need to deal with one slot. Can't have that. That one's broaching. Alright. Shit has to happen. So, the neck gets removed and we begin. Oh, my aching back. This hasn't happened in years. Why did this happen? Because I went back to work. And I'm walking on cement floors. With, torque that up a bit. Walking on cement floors with steel-toed work boots like a ding-dong. I'm over 60, guys. Screw this. Anyway, I went back to work as a favor. Now I'm captive. I don't know what to tell you. Okay. Let's make the neck as straight as we can possibly make it. That would be the wood part of the neck. Because what happens is when I bang all the frets into it, things can get wiggly. Better spin that around. So right now, if I do the light test, we got a bit of a back bow, which would be understandable because I straightened it out when it had string tension on it. So I'll just release that guy about a quarter turn. I can just sort of feel the straight edge. I might want to turn that back where it was. And the other thing we'll do is we'll get that 4 thou feeler gauge out. Just have a look. It's got a little ka-chink in the fingerboard there. We're good, we're good, we're good, we're good, we're good, we're good. Good, 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 good. Okay, so the wood is straight. But now, do something different. This is just a demonstration. If I put a flat edge across the frets, we're going to find some... We're good, we're good. Oh, now we start to get relief. Right? And then we choke at the high end of the fingerboard. So... double checking the fact that the wood is straight, and I'll put it up in the light here. No, the fingerboard's perfect. The frets are gone wiggly, so let's just level her out. It won't take much. All right, let's just look at that again. Right when I, and this is what's making the whole thing choke when we try to set it up. It's like we're good. We get a bit of relief, which we shouldn't have because the wood is straight, and then the frets hump up at the back end. So for the most part, when we level, most of it's going to come off here. Stand by. So I'm just going to tape it up. The fingerboard radius is a 9.5. I will use a 9.5. Oh no, that just shouldn't have happened. I'll use a 9.5. radius block to level things, and somebody likes me all at once. Oh God, the pressure. Yeah, so I'm just taping away here. A few of you will have known that I was fooling around with the live stream thing. Oh my God. Wow. It's interesting to see how vile and just unbelievably belligerent people can be. I didn't know people like that watched my YouTube channel. Or maybe that's their fun in their basement. I don't understand that. right? Dave's doing a live stream. Let's make shitty comments. Let's throw out insults. Let's be an asshole. I don't get it. But what I do get, as I get into it, problem is the people that do this aren't aware that the fact that, you know, for the most part, you can, you know, nobody's, like, comment in my videos any way you want. I barely read them. So basically, you're just yelling at the sky. But in a live stream, not only am I exposing myself to the public, so are you. And I've come to realize that I can actually flag your comments to a point where you might even lose your Google account or, I don't know. You gotta watch what you say, folks. Like, really. It might sound like fun, but we're not in the same room together, right? It might seem like a joke, but we're all not around the same table. So it comes off as something less than favorable. You know, and hey, I like a good joke too. That's too wide. I like a good joke. But, you know, when you got 50 people carving you all at the same time for no good reason, just because you're trying to do something good and fun, that gets a little disparaging. So anyway, we had fun in the live stream. I hope I educated a few people as to, you know, don't swear. Don't, you know, if even if you go, hey, this shit is great, the bots flag it, right? So, how about this stuff is great? We'll use that terminology. But if you start getting on me, like, wow. There was some stuff there, and like I said, I don't know if anybody was reading it the time I shut it all off. It was like, some goof was questioning my sexuality, which, to me, I don't care what you do at home. You can go blow a donkey if you want. I don't need to know about it. Have fun on your own. Entertain yourself any way you see fit, as long as no one gets hurt. But, you know, it's just like, come on. Can't we just be who we want to be? Can't we just be good to each other? Maybe once in a while, like, try to, like, throw out a positive vibe towards the next person that's beside you, even if that person is all, like, stinky and smells like piss and doesn't have a nickel and has no frickin' teeth. Could you toss that person, like, just, like, even some consideration? Like, just
while I'm taping
this off, I'm going to tell a story, and maybe somebody will get it, maybe people won't. Many, many years ago, filming on location in downtown Toronto, you know, and we were on that street for a week. It's the same homeless dudes. It's the same homeless people on the corners, right? And we're eating craft service and, you know, coffee's free, sandwiches are free, donuts, whatever you want, right? So there was this one guy that I saw there every day. You know, first day I went, hey, man, here, have a sandwich. I get as many as I want. And then next day I said, here, you know, in the morning I said, hey, buddy, I'm standing there. I'm running a steam boiler machine right beside a homeless guy who has nothing. And by the third day, I started talking to him, right? Like, he started, I shouldn't say I started talking to him. He started talking to me. And I heard his story out of his own mouth, right? And he pointed at the, you know, we were talking, and he's not in very good shape. He says,
He goes, I used to be a lawyer. And he pointed at the big Bank of Montreal tower that's 60 stories high that we could see from the corner. He said, I used to have an office on the 40th floor. Right? He goes, had a beautiful wife, two children. Right? And now I'm going, wow, what happened? Right? And he goes, my wife and my two children were killed in a car accident. Right? This guy's like telling me, I was a lawyer up in that tower. This is what happened to me. And he goes, I never recovered. I couldn't come back. He goes, I drank and I took dope and I just gave up on life. That's a real story about a real person. You don't know who anybody is at all.
Okay, let's get leveling. Remember when I was doing the feeler gauge thing and it's all humpy here? And we always want to level from the treble to the bass, right? This sandpaper looks pretty good. I might have to change it. And I'm looking, right? Everything else is peeling down except those buggers at that one end. Like I said, this really wasn't that badly out of whack. There wasn't a lot of fret wear. I'm thinking we got a pretty good set of flats there. I'm a-thinking, but we're going to give it a little extra help at this end, just because I know that sucked. Spin that guy around. Yeah, and I can see down here too, like the suspect frets are the ones that have been ground down to something where they should have been in the first place. I think we got that. Headphones, turn them up. Turn them up, turn up your headphones. Okay, we'll just let the camera roll, it doesn't matter. Now we're gonna blue again. Look how artistic I am. Almost think I, nope, see I blew it. My Picasso was ruined. Right then, crowning file time. The medium crowning file is your friend. I've been asked this many times. What crown? Medium. Everybody's medium is a little different. So the way to figure it out is once you've got flats, put the crowning file on the fret and have a look from the side in here. And the crowning file should not touch the fingerboard. Right? It should not touch the fingerboard. I'll be back. All right, back to this crowning file. I know it comes from the people I don't like. Many times I've been asked, why do I hate? I don't hate. Hate is a very powerful word. Dislike, unpleasured, less than happy, dissatisfied. Hate is like, come on. That's what starts wars. Let's not use the hate word. Anyway, this is really good. It's really good. It's all curved and stays away from things. And it's diamond and you can go both directions.
and it makes very fast work of this, and it's really expensive. So unless you're doing this all the time, there's no point, right? I used to get by with the old style files for a long time, until I started doing this a lot for a lot of people, and I went, this is taking way too long. Those are all looking really good. So one side is 150 grit. The other side is 300, which we'll do next. Then we begin to perform the magic.
So after much trial and error and looking at everyone else's techniques, because once again, there are no rules, only guidelines. Someone pointed out that a guideline is a rule. I don't know how to analyze that. Anyway, this is a big, heavy piece of rubber. Some guys use business cards or a stack of, whatever. Turn up your headphones. This is 320 grit. Remember, the crowning file was 300 grit. So. This will get rid of all the heavy abrasions. Turn up your headphones. That's what we get after flapping. Next, I've graduated to fret erasers. It's like the Martians have landed once I got those. Fret erasers from Hosco. You can Google it. They're all different grits and they work great. Right? I used to fart around with sandpaper. And then I discovered these. Next, we're going to polish them. What I'm using is top secret, but it's just metal polish. This is actually cymbal polish. You know, so if your cymbals are shiny, back again to, I see the guys use the wheel on the Dremel, and it's just like, oh, someone likes me. What was I doing? Oh, I was polishing the frets. Metal polish. Right, back to the Dremel wheel thing. It's just like, all that happens is you fill up that little wheel with shit, and you're really not getting it. If I really wanted to try that, I would do that after I did all this with nothing on this little guy. I don't use it. I use this for a different job, but that's top secret.
That's what came off by hand. I'm pretty sure your little Dremel wheel would be full of nothing spinning in the dirt. I quit. Let's pull out the tape.
So, the rest of this video is going to be another video. I just thought I'd demonstrate this one more time. It's not that tough if you have the right stuff. If you don't have the right stuff and the right knowledge, don't try this on a guitar you like. Fret leveling, crowning, and polishing is really fun about the first 10 times. That's all I gotta say. It's really an adventure about the first 10 times. And after that, it's just work. You're not gonna you might discover something new. I'm trying to share things. New abrasive materials, right? Once you get past the grounding files, it's like however you want to polish them, that's up to you. All right. That is looking amazing. Just going to give the fingerboard a little oil and put it back together for part two with the big setup. Woohoo! The big Stratocaster setup. Thanks for hanging out, folks. All the links to things are below in the description. I hope everybody's being safe and just, you know, it's disparaging out there. I don't like looking at the news, but I do once a day. So with that being said, folks, be good to each other. Be safe. Be healthy. Cheers.